Hey everybody, so looks like great news. The S&P 500 did come through up almost 1.4% yesterday. And in the overnights, it's down slightly, but that's okay. And the reason why this is good news is not because the S&P was up almost 1.4%. It was because gold just collapsed in the last hour. It was up big. And if you listen to my video yesterday, I talked about how when gold and S&P are up during the same day, then that usually means that the S&P 500 will be down the next day. So what happened was gold and S&P were up at the same time, and I thought, well, it's going to be a down day tomorrow for the S&P 500, but then gold sort of collapsed in the last hour. So that means if you're long stocks, it should be pretty much a good day. You know, you might be down a little bit, but you don't have the issue of gold and the S&P 500 being up at the same time, because when that happens, that's usually bad news for stocks in the short and sometimes intermediate term. Now, if you're long gold, don't worry. This is just sort of a natural sort of flushing out, because look how big gold has gotten. Look, in the last month, it was at 170, went all the way up to 193, and then now has come back down to 179. So if you look at a longer chart of gold, it may have to come back to about the 170 level before it continues going back up. I'm long gold as well, and I'm not worried about it at all. I mean, if you look at this sort of the long-term trend, this is a very nice chart you see here. And if you look at this sort of anomaly here for the past month, I mean, look at this, like a little mountain here. So, you know, just it's got to consolidate for a while, and that's fine. I'm actually a little more concerned about the S&P 500, because if you look at this chart, this is just like something you don't naturally see in a lot of charts, where you have this really steep decline and then this really sort of violent uptrend. I know some people have referred to this as a bear market rally, and it might be, because this is what a bear market rally looks like. And you have the election coming up, and I think there's going to be a lot of uncertainty, and I'm going to even go further and say there's going to be a lot of chaos with the election. And if we don't have a winner with the election on November 4th, if there's not a clear winner, there's just going to be a lot of chaos. There is just going to be, and that's not going to be good for stocks. It'll be good for gold, but it's not going to be good for stocks. And remember, we're heading into September now, which is seasonally the worst month of the year for stocks and seasonally the best month of the year for gold. So just keep that in mind. I've pretty much pared back just about all of my equity, my stock holdings, and I'm going to stay in gold through September, because I think September is going to be a good month for gold. I have no idea what's going to go on with equity, but you know, it's kind of like, you know, bank your profits when you have them, don't get greedy, like that old saying, you know, pigs get slaughtered, bulls and bears make money. So going forward, I say it's probably going to be a good day today for the S&P 500. It's probably going to be a good day on Friday as well, but as we head into the third week, expiration week in August next week, you may just want to be a little cautious. If you've made a lot of profit, take your profit. Don't get greedy. Don't try to squeeze every penny of the stock market. So I hope you enjoy this. I come up with updates every weekday. If you like it, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you very much. Bye.